EACC acknowledges that corruption still remains a big threat to the government of our, to the governance of our country. We admit that although a lot has been achieved in the anti-corruption cause, much more remains to be done. And that is why the multi-agency team is putting all the efforts. And together with the CID, the DPP, we are working together to make sure that the government resources are not wasted by the corrupt people. The Commission lauds the President's sentiments on 30th August that the government will make corruption a very unprofitable enterprise for those still with the courage to attempt in it in spite of the prosecutions we have witnessed today. We also acknowledge the increased support from other stakeholders, agencies involved in the anti-corruption law enforcement as well as the general public. Events of the last few months have demonstrated to all of us that when the nation comes together for a particular purpose, it's possible to achieve any desired outcome. We will continue to build on the milestones that we have made so far as we strive to do much more. Some of the notable milestones made in the last financial year only, EACC, in the last financial year, we finalized 183 files on corruption and economic crimes and submitted to the Office of the Director of Public Prosecution. Out of 183, 135 were recommended for prosecution and 14 for administrative action. 49 cases were finalized in court, out of which 39 resulted in convictions. We traced 14 illegally acquired public assets, estimated at 2.3 million. And the court processes for recovery are ongoing, and some have actually been recovered. Out of these assets, 352 million have since been recovered and returned to the public. We disrupted networks through proactive covert investigations and averted possible loss of public funds estimated at 4.2 billion. We filed three petitions in the High Court for removal from office of three state officers for violation of Chapter 6 of the Constitution. This will result like fighting, all those things. We are aware that even as we intensify these efforts, the corrupt are innovative and on YouTube. And he said, if you've noticed that most of the cases relate to procurement, and most of the cases relate to abuse of office and conflict of interest. They say, if you are in charge of a commission or you are in charge of a ministry, and your procurement officers are abusing the office and actually taking money and taking the loot, you are also responsible. And if we go that way, we make sure that the top, the heads of departments are also responsible for what happens down there. Because you cannot be head of a department and then 600-700 million is lost and you claim not to know. Definitely there is a way the head of department knows. And there is a way maybe they are giving directives through the mouth, saying, lipa huyu, fanya hivi. So the president said, finally, you are also liable to prosecution because you are also aware of what is going on in your department. So kindly, I would like to beg you as the commissions, members of the commission, kindly take responsibility of the junior officers in your department. And tell, and when, you know, sometimes the PSS and the ministers are too senior and when they give directives, I think the junior ones will be afraid to talk against it. But you can just say, excuse me, sir, this is against the procurement method. Excuse me, madam, this is against the procurement law. If you are instructed to pay something which you know is not correct, because finally, you know why some people cannot be taken to court? And I know some people have wondered why some people have not been taken to court. Now, this is my third year at the commission, I've realized. The senior most people do not sign anything. Nothing. You sit and try to look for evidence to take them to court. Out ayona. Anapiga tu simu. Hello, madam. Hello, Mr. Kiari. Pay this contractor. Pay that. Pay that. You are the one who signs the check. You are the one who signs the tender forms. You are the one. Tender committees have been taken to court, but the senior people, you can never find a place where they have signed. So take care, because finally it's just you who will be in the hot soup. Because you cannot take somebody to court when you have no evidence. Can you? Can you take somebody to court and say, aliniambia na mdomo? Ati PS alinipigia simu akaniambia nilipe madam so and so. How? It cannot stand in court. You'll be the one who will go to jail with your children and your assets will be frozen. So just say no to what you think is wrong.